In this fifth video on syllogisms, let us look at either or conclusions. So in the conclusions, you will have one or more conclusions which have the words either or in the conclusion. Let us see how to tackle those problems. So you will have some statements, and in the conclusion you will have either or. So look at this particular statement. Either or is there. So whenever we have either or in the conclusions, how do we tackle the problem? So drawing the diagrams remain the same. Let us see how we can draw this particular statements. Some thicker or slimmer. Some thicker or slimmer. All slimmer are cute. All slimmer are cute. Some cute are lean. So I can draw this way. Some cute are lean. Some cute are lean. Also do this way. Some cute are lean. Some cute are lean. Some cute are lean. So I have drawn it in four different ways. When you have either or as the option, okay, look at the conclusion C1, C2. You have four different diagrams that you have drawn. Your conclusion, you also have to look at it vertically. Let me just solve this first. Some thicker are not cute. Some thicker are not cute. So here I have gotten some thicker which are not cute. So I put that as a tick. Here all the thickers are cute. So it's a cross. Some thicker are not cute, which is this area, which is true. And all of the thickers are cute. So this is a cross. Okay. Just bear with me for a minute. When you have either or, don't stop when you get a cross. You finish the entire conclusion for all the diagrams and you see whether it's a tick or cross for all the diagrams. Second one, all thicker are cute. So all thicker are cute is true. Oh sorry, here all thicker are not cute. Okay, all thicker are cute is false, because we have this area which is not cute. All thicker are cute is false. All thicker are cute. This area is true. All thicker are cute is false, because you have this area which is not cute. And all thicker are cute is this area which is true. When you have either or, the first thing you have to do is to put the tick or cross in all the diagrams. Don't stop the moment you get one cross. If you have one of the options as either or, you fill the entire table with crosses or ticks. Okay. Now once you fill it, you see this option. When you have either or, see only one doesn't follow. Only two doesn't follow. So we would say neither one nor two follows. No. When you have either or, you see. For any diagram, you will have either conclusion one follows or conclusion two follows. So in diagram one, conclusion one only follows. Conclusion two does not follow. In diagram 2, conclusion 1 does not follow, conclusion 2 follows. In diagram 3, conclusion 1 follows, but conclusion 2 does not follow. In diagram 4, conclusion 1 does not follow, conclusion 2 follows. So if you see, either conclusion 1, whichever diagram you draw, conclusion 1 or conclusion 2 is definitely true. If you draw diagram 1, this is true. If you draw diagram 2, this is true. If you draw diagram 3, this is true. If you draw diagram 4, this is true. So any diagram you draw, there is no where a possibility that both will be crosses. That is what this means. Either or means there is no option where both can be crosses. Okay, both can be crosses is not possible. So whenever you have either or, sorry, whenever you have either or, you draw, first thing you have to do is to draw crosses or ticks in all the different diagrams for all the conclusions. Draw crosses or ticks for all the different conclusions in all the potential diagrams. So I have not stopped at this cross. I have put crosses and ticks everywhere. Then secondly, you see if both are crosses. Here we don't have a situation where both are crosses. Either in a diagram one is tick and one is cross, or one is cross and other is tick. We don't have both crosses. Hence, either one or two follows. So you will have either conclusion one true or conclusion two which is true. Let us look at this problem again. Here we have either one or two follows in the option, so we have to be careful. Let us draw all the different possible diagrams for this. No armrest is a seat cover. No armrest is a seat cover. All seat covers are headrests. Okay. So you might have another possible way to draw it. No armrests are seat covers. All the seat covers are headrests. And a third way to draw it is no armrests are seat covers. All the seat covers are headrests. I have only three ways in which I can draw the given statements. And I have two conclusions. So conclusion 1, conclusion 2, 3 diagrams. So remember, since you have either or, you have to fill this entire table with ticks and crosses. Conclusion 1 is no headrest is an armrest. So I have conclusion 1 which is true in the first diagram. No headrest is armrest is false here. Some headrest are armrest. No headrest is armrest is also false here. And so I have gotten this as crosses. Some headrest are armrest. We see that some headrests are not armrest, which we get that as true. Oh, sorry, some headrests are not armrest. So this is false here because there's no overlap. Then some headrests are armrest is true in the second diagram here, and some headrests are armrest is true in the third diagram. So I have filled this now. Now only one does not follow, only two does not follow. Now when I have either or option, let us look at this. When it is diagram 1, I should ensure that I don't have both crosses vertically. Either 1 or 2 follows, I should not have both crosses vertically. So, in the first diagram, conclusion 1 is true. In the second diagram, conclusion 2 is true. In the third diagram, conclusion 2 is true. So, either I will have conclusion 1 as true or I will have conclusion 2 as true. This is what it means. So, there is no diagram where both conclusion 1 and conclusion 2 are false. Hence, my answer is either 1 or 2 follows. You might have a few problems of this type, either 1 or 2 follows. You don't have to worry too much about it. But whenever you get either 1 or 2 follows, ensure that you fill the entire table. Even if you get a cross, you fill the entire table that you got with ticks and crosses. And then you see vertically and ensure that you don't get a diagram where both the conclusions are false. Here, in this diagram, one conclusion is true. In this diagram, the other conclusion is true. In this diagram, the other conclusion is true. Hence, you can do either one or two follows. So, you've seen all the different types of problems. You've seen all the different types of statements that are used. Some, all, some not, maybe. Then we looked at the possibility option and saw how those could be solved. We looked at either or. All of these help you become masters in Sumachism. If you want more modules, you want more topics, more practice, please visit our website 777.com. Sign up and log in to the Master Learner package or to different modules. Take up the company specific tests and become successful. Also visit our YouTube channel 777 Aptitude Prep. Like, subscribe and share. And thank you so much for your time, and I hope you watch the final video on syllogism, which is about reverse syllogism, which is next. Thank you.